Like anything else, toxicity is always the priority. You want to make sure that your patients are safe. We are making progress in that regard. We are learning more and more on how to manage the toxicity and how to decrease the risk of these toxicities, namely cytokine release syndrome and neurotoxicity. So to pick the right patient at the right time, then do the right intervention. So I would say side effect or adverse event management would be one. From the practical standpoint, it is becoming a crowded space to bring new CAR Ts or new combinations to the disease, to the patient level. And, you know, having an FDA-approved CAR T cell is great, but at the same time, it sets the bar much higher for bringing a new CAR T to the patient level, which is a good problem to have, but at the same time, it will slow down, for example, enrollment on clinical trials and waiting for the sequencing strategies between the CAR T and some other great drugs that are also on the horizon. So again, I would say this is a good problem, but makes clinical research a little bit slower than before. And I'm sure with the large group of investigators, this will be feasible.